Hey everybody, welcome to day two of the Vacation Vodcast. So first up we had the Dark Souls 3 Ashes of Ariandel DLC. And for day two I have something that I've been wanting to do for a while now, and that is to do kind of a grab bag of a bunch of recently released indie games, just because I think there's a lot of interesting concepts or ideas or just really silly things that are just kind of fun to experience for a little while. So for today's vodcast, I selected five recently released slash popular indie games. So we have five total, and they're a mix across a bunch of genres, so I hope you guys enjoy it. And first up, we have Check Please. So just to give you a preface, I'll read you the description they had on their itch.io page. Check Please is a physics-based dating sim. As the player, you have to keep your date happy and make it a success by performing niceties for your potential partner. So, as someone who is in a successful relationship, I figured this would be a very good test for me. You know, I should be pretty easy, I think, as a functioning social human to behave at dinner. So, let's go ahead and see how our date night will go in Check Please. Very, very nice looking woman. She, kind of an emoji looking face. Bit of a plain face. It's a little dark in here. Can you light the candle? All right. So, we're a disembodied hand here. And is there a way to lower myself? Oh, no, that's a knife. Or a spoon, rather. How do I lower my hand? Maybe I tilt it? No. This is being a bit of a finicky thing. As soon as I figure out how to lower my hand, the woman, I will get to you, I promise. It seems like we cannot move along the z-axis, it would seem. Ah, there it goes. Okay, so you have a hover over it. Okay, there we go. Good enough. Okay. Some wine for the lace lady. Before we burn down this restaurant, apparently. Let's just slowly approach the bottle. Slowly pour. Oh no, that's on the table. I'll pull back a little bit. Oh. This actually is not too far from the truth. Oh, I have to go over to her? Oh, whoops. Wine in your head. Let's give her a cup of wine. There you go. Is that good? Does that satisfy you? Ah yes, cheers. To many successful dates in the future. Oh, she is having none of this. Hey, what was wrong with my wine pouring, though? Oh no. Ah, this didn't go quite as well as I had hoped. I'm handling this how I handle it after a bottle of Yellowtail. Not a good time. Alright, is there... wonder what her patience level is. Oh. Check, please. Alright, that was a bit of a mess. Alright, I got a feel for the hand now. Let's try it a little. Alright. Let's see if this goes a little smoother. Alright, look, first phase, pretty easy. Leave this in the corner. Could you pour us some wine? I wonder, maybe I pour too much wine. Let's pour a proper amount of wine. That looks good. Oh no, put it back in your hand. Oh my god. Oh my god. It spawns in the same place as my cup. This is a catastrophe. Come on, work with me here. Okay, just put the two cups on the table. Alright, there we go. We can work with this, though. I'm guessing if the two cups are full. Okay, there. Nice. We don't need that wine anymore. Can you feed me 3 meatballs? What the hell kind of date is this? Okay. Just pop it in her mouth? I guess. Can we just give her- oh, yes. Luckily... Was that- wait, was that good or bad? I can't tell. Wait, did I win? Did I do it? Okay, I'm gonna try it one more time. To make sure that was indeed the end. Very good. She has a mustache this time though, so maybe it's a different... Maybe this is a different level? Probably not. Oh no, that's spaghetti. I don't want spaghetti. I want these little poop looking meatballs. Right into the gullet. That's your wine. Right down the gullet. Oh, I guess that is the end. So what else can we touch here? Can we just throw everything off the table if we want? Can we stab her? Obviously, this is the first reaction to a date. No. She makes her a little upset, but no stabbies. Alright, that just makes her angry. Alright. Well, this was our first little indie game. Check, please. You know, nice little experience. I wouldn't mind this being fleshed out to have a few more date scenarios, because it's kind of fun too. The idea of manipulating objects on a table. And this, I like the song too. Nothing else, the music was nice. So I hope you guys enjoyed our first game. Let's move on to what we have next. All right, let's move on to our second game in our indie game roundup, SCP-3008. And let me tell you a little bit about this game and kind of why it just sounded so ludicrous. And just interesting, just based on the concept. A game set in the SCP universe based on SCP-3008, an endless IKEA. The good thing is, food stores get restocked every now and then. You won't starve. The bad thing is that the staff tries to kill you as soon as the lights go out. Barricade yourself with furniture, battle the staff, and survive as many days as you can. So, you know, as a horror lover, I've always had a soft spot for the SCP universe. And I think they do a lot of neat things with the, you know, it's just kind of creative what people come up with these like cursed objects and places or monsters. And out of all the choices you have, you know, it was picked to use the IKEA as a setting for a game. So let's go ahead and hop into this and see what this is all about. All right, Waz move. All right, we could pull this up. We need it. Cool. Huh. This is a lot nicer than I expected. It's almost like an IKEA. I like the ambient music too. So, I guess the lights go out eventually and we have to barricade ourselves. Is this food? Pasta? I thought it was only Swedish meatballs. What the hell is this? Is that supposed to be pasta? Do I eat it? What do I do with it? Use item left click? Okay. Do I have to cook it? Oh, that's pasta. Okay. Maybe we cannot eat undercooked pasta. Some nice lamps. Press G to break the lamp. A broken lamp can be used as an electric weapon. However, it will sooner or later break. What? The lamp is broken. Before it breaks completely, it can be used as a weapon or trap. Oh! So we can make a... Make traps for our little base. Alright, how strong is our guy? Can he pick up couches? No. Pillows? Pillows are not real. And do benches. Alright, we can make a little bench base here in the park. This could work. Let's make a little square base for us. Bet you can't rotate objects. Alright, this seems, you know, pretty reasonable. We can jump. We can get some help from these other benches. God, that is a goddamn horrendous noise. It reminds me of the noise the chip machines make when you put your credit card in and they're warning you to take it out. So let's fill up these cracks. I don't know what these enemies are gonna look like. People, maybe? I don't know what an IKEA employee looks like. I don't know if they're gonna be like monstrous or not. Not too sure what to expect. Let's stick that. Can we jump over this? Oh, I gotta make sure I leave space for us. Looks like we can jump over most of this stuff, though. Let's fill up our holes. I just want some lamps. We're gonna go full base building here. Full tower defense. I mean, there's no timer, it seems. I don't know how long we have to build. Our burger. G to collect. Okay. This is food. And I have a billiard stick. I guess that's my defense. How do I eat it? How do what am I supposed to do with it? That's cute. You died on one day because you used a dev command? Go kill yourself. What are you talking about, dude? I'm just playing the game. Guys, problem. Okay. I guess I did something bad. I was trying to eat the food. I was trying to eat the burger you put in your game, asshole. Jeez. Do I have to put it in my inventory? F, put object in inventory. I ate it. Okay, I smashed all the buttons on the keyboard. And it worked. Alright, let's try it. Let's take two. Let's build another base. Let's make another park base. Oh, maybe we can make a big circle out of all these chairs. Yeah. That'll totally work, right? Probably not. Let's make a nice little lawn arrangement. I bet you can't push things. There's no, like, collision with objects, it looks like. You're like this, a movable force. Let's see if we can actually get to a knight before I apparently use a dev command. Trying to eat a goddamn hamburger. Holy sh! God, I hate that noise. Probably like top three worst noises right now. Just because you hear it everywhere. I think in like Target though, they've replaced that with a more pleasant noise. More of a chime. Which I can get behind. Let's finish. Let's make sure our corners are barricaded well. Probably need to shore up this side. Yeah. These chairs. I trust that the chairs will hold off well. Alright, let's take our lamps. These lamps will be our true defense. If it stay upright. No. Come on. Work with me here. Wait, what? What the hell is this? Where did these guys come from? Wait, did I spawn things? Is that me? Oh goodness. I don't understand anything that's going on. I think I accidentally spawned those guys by pushing the number keys. My bad. I didn't realize that the number keys are apparently bound to do debug things. But where do they go? Where do the enemies go? They just ran off. Probably to go restock some meatballs. None of these goddamn lamps stay upright. Truly a disappointment. I kinda just want to explore the IKEA. I don't even care about building a barricade. Noclip activated? No, I don't want a noclip. I just want to play the game! Okay. I ate the food. We're good. I gotta say, this is kind of a pleasant SCP. Like, of all the places I can get stuck, like, an IKEA seems reasonable. Are there books in IKEA? I guess you would just go crazy. It's magazines. I wonder where he got that image from. Think of all the interior designing you could test out. Look, there's books. Actufa? Actipona? What the hell? Oh, you could pick up the pick up the whole thing. Yeah, see, there's entertainment. I still have a way to get in here. Yeah, I can jump over here. Cool. I hope I didn't, like, ruin something with my accidental pressing of debugging things. Huh. I wonder how long we have until nighttime. Oh, okay. Well, that answers my question. Ah, shit. Actually, I'm not too sure where... it's over here. Cool. Wait. Fuck me. Where did I leave? Where did I make the barricade? This is really disorienting, actually. I think... was it in this general direction? It kind of looks like... no. I mean, are there enemies? God damn it. Maybe I could just make another barricade on the fly here. Maybe that's what I have to do. Okay, emergency barricade time. I don't see anyone. Maybe it's a little easier this first time. Let's hunker down. And maybe when it's light out, I should have put like a lamp or something in front of the outpost or a little barricade. Okay, is this good enough? And this is not the most complex game. Like, if I can't fit through it, I doubt whatever is gonna come after us will be able to fit through it either. Which is this it? This deformed IKEA employee? Is this the enemy? This doesn't do anything. What if I took- can he kill me? Oh, he takes swipes at me.
Door is now closed. Please leave the building.
Well, I would leave if I could. This is so bizarre. So they just punch me?
Excuse me, the store is now closed. Please exit the building.
Alright, SCP-3008. You know, I had hopes. I had hopes on the concept. But, you know, I don't think it was, this didn't quite come into fruition. I mean, I may as well- I mean, we're invincible, apparently. I made sure the god mode is not on, either.
The store is now closed. Please
May as well. It's like a minor annoyance. What does this model even look like? Like a melted face. A very long torso. Alright, I think I've had enough of this. Let's move on to the next thing. Number 3, hopefully better than SCP IKEA edition. So next we have Detective Wolf, and this is taken from Itch.io, I think. So Itch.io seems to run these events called game jams, and they're all themed around things, and people just submit their games that are made in a certain span of time to this competition. And I think this competition was Unreal Engine Spring Games. So I'm not really sure. I guess I don't really know how Detective Wolf relates to that, but I was looking at games under there, and it looked neat. So let's see what we're in for. You are a detective with a dark secret living in a small town. Under a full moon, you transform into a wolf with an appetite for flesh. The townsfolk are aware that some unseen monster haunts their town and actively search for it at night. When transformed into a wolf, your hunger must be sated, but what remains of your humanity dictates you only hunt those that are guilty of the most terrible crime, murder. During the day, you can investigate by speaking to the people in the town, the e-key to ask about their alibi, and again to question them about the crime. When you question everyone and are confident who the killer is, hold space to wait until night to serve justice. During the night, E allows you to smell people, and space allows you to kill them. Be careful not to get spotted by any innocent townsfolk. At night, you will only be able to tell people apart by their smell. Use the information in their alibi to learn what a person will smell like. Okay, I'm actually kind of excited. This sounds interesting. Let's start on easy. Now we have another option. Good morning, Detective Wolf. It looks like Abigail was on her... Okay, it's not... See, usually it's me reading poorly. This sentence is wrong. It seems like Abigail was walking home last night, and she was attacked and killed. We think the murderer acted alone, but there are no suspects at this time. Your task is to investigate the townsfolk and find out what they know. Those who are innocent will always tell the truth. Those involved with the murder, either as the perpetrator or as an accomplice, will always lie. When you identify the killer, move to nighttime. Okay. Remember, at night, only your nose will be able to distinguish between townsfolk. So Abigail was walking home and was killed. Alright, let's get to the bottom of this. Hello, Ashley. I never really knew Abigail. No reason I'd have done anything to her. Anyway, I was too busy smelting iron to knock her off. I've looked into Cassandra's heart. There's no way she could have done this. So Ashley will smell like iron, and she says Cassandra would not have done this. I'll be the judge of that. Cassandra, I didn't touch Abigail. I was gardening when it happened. Ask anyone. I'd bet it was either Sarah or Nick is behind this. They always hated Abigail. Alright, so our two leads are Sarah and Nick. Cassandra and Ashley seem to be in the clear. I didn't even really know Abigail. I'm so busy painting. In fact, I was painting my house when she went missing. Abigail always hated Ashley and Sarah, and they hated her right back. Ah? Okay. So it seems like Sarah might be the person? As Nick said, does not even know Abigail. It's a lonely job making cheese. Of course I don't mind it. Abigail never really did like cheese, though. Ashley has a reputation to uphold. There's no way he'd lie to a detective. She'd lie, I guess. So Ashley would not lie to me. What did Ashley say? And Ashley says it wasn't Cassandra. So I'm pretty sure Sarah is the murderer. Right, let's go. Let's hunt this killer. Press. Oh, she smells like cheese. She smells like cheese. Okay. We gotta sniff out the cheesemaker. This is, as we are, a little wolf. Ah! You were detected by an innocent person. If the killer was to go missing tonight, your cover would be blown. You'll have to come back another night. Oh, okay. Fresh paint. I kinda like this, art style, though. Smelted iron. Raw manure. Oh! Fuck. They track you. jeez. Just hop on her. Look how bloody we are, jeez. Wait, what? You had the following clues. Cassandra said, I'd bet that either Sarah or Nick is behind this. They always hated Abigail. They were telling the truth. You killed the wrong person. The killer was Nick. Really? Huh. Who's lying to me? Nick said Abigail always hated Ashley and Sarah. They hated her right back. I bet that either... There are terrible grammar in this. I bet either Sarah or Nick is behind this. They always hated Abigail. Huh. Was I able to deduce this? Ashley has a reputation to uphold. There's no way she'd lie to a detective. Oh, I guess that was true. And I guess that would only leave Nick as the liar if everyone else was true. Okay. Let's try this again. Abigail's dismembered body was found dumped near the river this morning. Let's try this again. Sophia. Such terrible news about Abigail. She was always so nice. Of course, I had nothing to do with it, as I was busy tending to my roses. If you ask me, it was Nick who killed Abigail. They'd always been at each other's throats. So Sophia is trying to put the blame on Nick. Okay. We'll see what Nick has to say about that. Francis. I never really knew Abigail. No reason I'd have done anything to her. Anyway, I was too busy smelting iron to knock her off. There's no way it could have been Sophia. She was always close to Abigail. This is Sophia. Okay. So Nick is my number one suspect now. Abigail could never hold her alcohol, of course. That never stopped me from serving her. There's no possible way Francis could have hurt Abigail. He just doesn't have it in her. I remember Abigail stealing apples from my orchard as a child. Never did think I'd outlive her. I've been out at my farm all week. There's no way I'm involved. Abigail always hated Jacob and Sophia, and they hated her right back. Abigail... Okay, I'm pretty sure it's Nick. Sophia seems to be in the clear. Sophia wouldn't lie to me, and Sophia also said... Oh, she said it was Nick. Okay, it's Nick then. Let me double check what Nick smells like. Apples? Or maybe manure? I'm not sure. Not sure what an apple orchard's supposed to smell like. Fruit? It's you. Okay, I feel confident about this one. Hey, you killed the right person. Alright, cool. Got it. Let's bump this up to medium. Charlotte's dismembered body was found dumped near the river this morning. We think... okay. Oh, so now we have five. We have five people to question now. Gavin. I'm a lonely cheesemaker. Charlotte never did like cheese, though. If you're looking at Kieran, you're looking in the wrong spot. He's an angel. What's Kieran? Never thought much about Charlotte. Kept to herself, really. Of course, it's the sharpest... shot in the town. I'll be looking for who did. If Gavin is telling you one thing, you should believe him. So Gavin and Kieran seem to be in the clear. They're probably not up there. I mean, down here. I trust Gavin and Kieran. Genevieve. Charlotte always did love my honey. My bees take up so much of my time, though. I've been so busy tending them. Charlotte always hated Susan and Kieran, and they hated her right back. Susan? Susan better have a good explanation for where she was. Emily. Excuse me, I'm so busy cooking. Shame about Charlotte, though. Last night I was home roasting, so there's simply no way I could have done it. I can't believe that Susan or Gavin could do something like this to Charlotte. Susan and Gavin were so close to her. Susan is number one. I'm a candle maker by trade, and boy did Charlotte sure love her candles. I've lost my best customer. I was making her a personalized candle when she went missing. I've looked into Gavin's heart and there's no way he could have done this. I want to say it was Susan, but I can't believe Susan or Gavin, because Gavin isn't lying. I don't think Gavin's lying. Let me go talk to Gavin one more time. You're looking at Kieran, you're looking in the wrong spot. Okay, it must be Susan. Wait, and she's making candles. She should smell like candles. Cheese. Honey. I don't think anything's up that way. I think they're all in the town down here. Gotta find the candlestick maker. Cooked meat. Candle wax. Let's get her. Oh, pretty. I killed the wrong person. It was Genevieve? What does Genevieve say? Charlotte always hated Susan and Kieran. They hated her right back. Hmm. If Gavin is telling you one thing, you should believe him. God damn it. Taylor was Genevieve. Let's try this again. Murder of Caitlin. Anyone hanging out up here? What is up here? This is dead area. I think this is just a dead zone. I think everything happens in this little town. Charlotte, I didn't even really know Caitlin. I'm so busy painting. I've always known that Francis or Sarah could do something like this. The poor Caitlin. They always hated her, the poor thing. Is Francis and Sarah. Maybe. Here. Is this a vat of paint? What is that supposed to be? I'm trying to think in the context of these people's jobs. Does that orange building look like a blacksmithing thing? Yeah, what do you have to say? Caitlin always hated Elijah and Charlotte. They hated her right back. Francis and Sarah. Elijah and Charlotte. Never thought of Caitlin. This person doesn't even have a scent. There's no way it could have been Sarah. Who's implicating Sarah? Francis or Sarah? So I'm suspicious of Charlotte right now. I never really knew Caitlin, no reason I would have done this. Anyway, I was too busy smelting iron. I knew Charlotte. She's a straight shooter. She'd never lie. Well, we could talk to Charlotte. Alright, let's talk to the last person. Apparently Charlotte should not be lying. Such terrible news about Caitlin. She was always nice. Of course, I had nothing to do with this. I was busy tending to my roses. If you're looking at Charlotte, you're looking at the wrong spot. She's an angel. Are those two people corroborating Charlotte? Okay, so I'm almost certain Charlotte can be trusted. Let me double check what she said. And she says it was either Francis or Sarah. So maybe they're in cahoots. And Francis is trying to blame Elijah and Charlotte. We know Charlotte can be trusted. So I think it's Francis. Yes, it must be Francis. He smells like alcohol. Alright, Francis, you're going down. Iron? When you're coming from this direction, it's really hard to... Oh, they do. These are smart townspeople. Rose petals? Where's my alcohol man? Ah, I guess they do travel up farther up the map. Are they on the farm over here? Ah. Alcohol. There we go. I'm almost certain it was Francis. I hope. Yes, okay, cool. Alright, let's see. Ha! Let's keep going. Sarah went missing last night. Her body was found in the woods, so Sarah is dead. Seven people. This is just pretty much a bunch of, like, if-then statements, right? Just trying to piece together our own story. So the information, so like their alibi isn't as important until I'm sure who did it. If you rule out Jesse, then I'm sure Jacob did it. He never liked Sarah. I didn't touch Sarah. Okay, now. I've looked into Jesse's heart and there's no way he could have done this. What did she say about Jesse? Could be Jacob. So Jacob is potential killer number one. I'm guessing once we get to seven people, they're gonna be more spread out. Jacob. I can't believe that Isabella or William would do something like this to Sarah. Isabella and William were so close to her. So Jacob is trying to blame other people for it. If you rule out both Jacob and Jesse, I take a closer look at Olivia. I have not ruled out Jacob yet, because two people have said Jacob could have done it. Let's take a look. Olivia. Let's see what Olivia has to say. If you prove Olivia didn't do it, then Isabella surely did it. Well, I haven't proved anything about Olivia yet. I'm curious to see what she says. Olivia. If you think Isabella is innocent, then my money is on William. Huh. I think Isabella is innocent. But then what did William say? Also, I have one more person. William said if you prove Olivia didn't do it, then Isabella surely did it. So right now I think it might still be Jacob. So Jesse didn't do it, and Jesse is telling us... Let's find Jesse. I don't think I've spoken to him yet. Although him hiding out... If he's hiding out all the way out here, a little fishy in my opinion. Is he like sitting in the woods or something? Or is there no one here? Now where is Jesse? Oh, look at this. Oh, in the graveyard. Oh, here he is. Jesse, excuse me. I'm pretty sure I saw Elijah with Sarah just before she went missing. Or maybe it was Olivia. She and Elijah look so alike. Okay. I'm pretty sure I saw Elijah and Sarah just before missing. Maybe it was Olivia. She and Elijah look so alike. So it was Olivia or Jacob, I think. I think it's Jacob. Let me double check what Jacob does for a living. Because I don't have enough information on Olivia, I don't think. And no one's implicated her unless Isabella didn't do it, and I trust Isabella. This is Jacob, right? Of course, this is the sharpest shot in the town. I'll be looking for dead. I think it was Jacob. He smells like gunpowder, I think. Okay. Smelted iron. He moves so fast as the wolf, it's nice. Hopefully it's Jacob. Where are you hiding? Do they patrol the same area where they were during the day? No. Gotta find the gunpowder. Come on, give me a break. God damn it. People are so perceptive. Smelted iron, fruit. Can't fit between those. Gotta find the gunpowder. Gunpowder murder. Cooked meat. He's so hard to find, he must be the killer. Hanging out at the graveyard? Oh. Hmm. Man, where is this dingus? Candlewax. That person should not be alone in the woods, though. Seems pretty dangerous when you know there's a wolf hunting all of you. Gunpowder? You killed the wrong person. Oh my god, it was Olivia! Damn it. Alright, I think I've had enough of Detective Wolf. This is it's a fun little game. Pretty simple, but you know, it's a cute concept of a wolf detective. So, overall, pretty good. It's nice to play this after the disappointment that was SCP-3008. So, hope you guys like this one, and let's see what we got next. Alright, moving on to our next game, and I will admit, this is probably the lowest hanging fruit, the silliest game, but just my affection for SpongeBob, and just like, it was highly rated on Game Jolt, so I'm not sure what that means, but, you know, I'm curious. And 3 a.m. at the Krusty Krab, maybe it's the best horror game I'll ever play, or maybe it'll just be a nice nostalgic look into the Krusty Krab at nighttime. I'm gonna guess this has something to do with the classic episode of the Krusty Krab being open overnight, potentially, and some kind of horror spin to that thing. But I know this is a little silly, but you know, maybe you guys will just get a kick out of seeing what this is about.
Money.
Oh, from Mr. Krabs' perspective, that's a new one. Okay. I mean, it's a little silly, but I kind of like seeing the office rendered in this environment. It looks pretty authentic. It's a bright ass light. Gather all me money from the cash register and from me office. Arr. Pack the leftover Krabby Patties. Check the bathroom trash bin for any pennies. Lock up and leave. Okay. This doesn't seem like the job. I don't think. I guess Mr. Krabs would be looking for things like that. He would pinch pennies in the bathroom. Okay, what? Oh, can I not go up here? Oh, I gotta go out here first. Oh, cinematic. Fancy. Is it the hash slinging slasher? Oh, he's our antagonist. When the lights flicker, you must hide. Hide where? In the office? Closing, barricading the office is the only way to escape him. Not very. Wait, what do we have to do? Alright, register Krabby Patties, check the bathroom. Okay. And go out back. It is 3 a.m. at the Krusty Krab. What is Mr. Krabs doing here so late? He's counting his money all night. Alright, let's pack up the Krabby Patties. It seems like the easiest one to do. Hey, where's Mr. Hashslinging Slasher? Oh, I didn't expect him to teleport behind us like that. Okay. Alright. Still a little jump scare. Do we have to watch this cutscene again? No. Is it wrong? I just want to see the restaurant. My drinks. Wait, he's in the office! What is this asshole? I didn't know he can get in here. Alright. Not playing by the rules. Okay. Wait. Is it the cash register? Oh, and me office. Okay. Hit the crouch. He seems too aggressive. And the lights will flicker on and off. So does this have, does this share a progress bar? Like if I stop midway, it will continue where it left off? Do I have, I can't, I gotta finish it, dude. Gotta finish it. Okay. Cool. We gotta get the Krabby Patties. Is there any strategy to this? Or do I just kinda gotta hope for the best? Seems like we've been pretty lucky so far. He's gonna be behind me again, maybe. Okay. We're gonna be done here. We just need the bathroom pennies. Don't even know where the bathroom is. I'm kidding. Who doesn't know? Doesn't everyone instinctually know the layout for the Krusty Krab? And they even got his little nautical flags. Oh wow, he's right there. Alright. I'm guessing he's just on a timer, and then we'll be able to do this. We're far from the office if he does show up. Wait. All objectives, find the key. In the basement? Why is the key in the basement? Is this the trapdoor? The key is somewhere in the basement, you must find it. But how do I, how do I hide? But he's... lame. Eh? I'm gonna assume he's right behind me. Can I go back up? Oh, I can't. Shit. I might die here. Okay, so I can outrun him. As long as he doesn't teleport on top of me. Where is this? Oh, I think we're in a dead end here. The basement is larger than the Krusty Krab. I mean, this is kind of reasonable. At least this is, I thought this was gonna be too punishingly hard. But at least you're able to outrun him. I'm gonna trust the footsteps in this game. Because it sounded like he was behind that wall. Okay. Nice. You have the key. Now go outside and lock up. I'm guessing this is what they're referring to. Oh, I have to leave out the front door? Okay. How do I lock it? Left mouse button. Can I get to the boat and escape? Alright, Pearl, we're coming home. Oh, he's behind us! You escaped! Wow, not a single appearance of Nosferatu. That was silly. It only took two tries though, so you know, it was a sweet little experience. You know, it was cool to see the Krusty Krab, you know. in a 3D space. And, you know, it wasn't too difficult. It got me a little scared once, so that's the most I could ask for. You know, out of the sea of indie horror games that I could have picked from, this one was a nice treat. So, much better than SCP. So, out of the two horror games I picked, I'm glad this one did not leave me terribly disappointed. So, I hoped you guys liked this little 3 AM with the Krusty Krab. It was it's cute. It's a cute little SpongeBob game. But with that, let's move on to our next game. All right, moving into our last game for this VOD of our grab bag indie games, we have the Foxy Thief, and like Detective Wolf, it is part of the Transformation Game Jam, which I'm gonna guess we're gonna transform into different stuff as the fox. Just to give you a little background information, the description here is: the Foxy Thief, control the red fox and get all the objectives. Be smart and don't get caught. You can transform yourself into other animals to hide yourself. Good luck. So, looks like this will also follow the transformation theme, of course. And I saved this one for the last because it looked the most promising. It looked very pretty from the screenshots, and I hope it lives up to what I'm hoping for. So let's go ahead and get into it. Right in the forest. Your objective: find and eat 10 pieces of meat. Press E to eat for 5 seconds. So we move. Oh, we got an attack in this game. Fight him. That's a pretty pitiful dodge. E to interact, R to transform, and shift to prowl, to walk. Okay. And P to pause. Alright, so we got our first 3 pieces of meat here. Cool. Thing over here. Unreal Engine Game Jam. There, you can see it up there. You can transform yourself inside these areas by pressing R. Okay. Oh! Oh, we're a little rabbit! No one expects the little rabbit. Oh, so cute. So cute. Okay. Dogs will be suspicious even if you are transformed. Stay alert. Okay. They don't mess around when we're a wolf, but if we're a rabbit, I guess they come after us. And they pop our cover. Hey, hey, asshole, get out of here. We're at 100 health. Would kill the dog? Oh no. I'm sorry. Did not mean to kill the dog. Good luck. Okay. So, we're in town. What, do we become a pig here? They never suspected us. Alright, do we kill these guys for meat? A durable pig. You drop some pork chops? No. I think it showed us what the meat looks like. I thought maybe it drops it. Whoa! Oh my god. These goats fight back, shit. Alright, we're not screwing with the goats. Oh my god. Is that a guard? Okay, I think we de-aggroed him. What the hell is yelling at me? Who is this? What is going on? Alright, we gotta go into cover. I didn't know this world was so dangerous for us. That's a dog. No, leave me alone. Yeah. Apparently this town has assembled a small army to combat this fox. Alright, this is very quaint. Where is their meat, though? Oh shit. Wait, what propped me? I'm not sure why my cover was blown. I guess I got too close to one of the people. Oh, do I? Get out of here, dude. Can I? Can the people get me up here? Oh no, okay. Sneaky fox on the rooftop. Okay, I see that up there. There's meat all over the center of town. There's also meat here. I wonder if this heals us. Hopefully it does. Oh no! Wait, how did this guy- Oh, there's stairs on this roof. I didn't notice. Okay. How do I- Oh, reset. Okay. Alright, I gotcha. I get it. I'm down with this. See how many pieces of meat we can manage to get. Also, what's this transformation over here then? Because it seems like the goats are also able to be perceptive enough to see through our disguise. Oh, we're gonna be a little duck? You know, the goose is probably more dangerous than the fox. These guys are little assholes. Alright, they'll never suspect me. Let's waddle into town, get the meat, and then we'll be good. Ah, ha, ha. I wonder if can we eat the meat while we're in duck form? And I don't think we have the necessary teeth to eat the meat. Oh, we can. Okay. Perfect. Oh, it de-transforms us. Those goats are hella loud. Okay. They haven't noticed us yet. He's noticed us now. We gotta get into the chicken coop. Hey, the transformation didn't work. I was sold lies. I guess they saw me transform. They are not easily fooled, these humans. I feel like I'm better off trying to platforming away from them. Is there just enough meat for us, or is there an excess? There's so many people in this small village. Where is the meat? Oh, over there. Okay, I think we can make it there. Alright, the dodge does work. It's not as much a dodge as much as it just gives us invincibility for a few seconds. Oh no! Ah! Almost lost him. We have a goddamn small army here. Come on. Come on, eat faster. That doesn't heal us either. That's lame. I was hoping it would. Jesus. Does this turn us into a cow? Rabbit. Alright. For whatever reason in this corner, I think it did it in the last round too. It just makes you yell. No, get out of here, dog. I'm glad you have owners to feed you, but not all the animals are that lucky. Okay, so you can eat the first piece of meat in disguise, and then it pops you out of disguise. Cool. Is there a way up here? Oh, there is. We outie. Aha. Alright, only four more left. Those cows are so loud. Alright, let's scout it out. in bunny form. It seems like they tend to be on the roof pretty often. Shoot. I think if I get too close to the people, they also snuff out my disguise. I gotta say, for a little indie game, I like this. This is a cute idea. To utilize the transform theme that they had. I'm not sure where these last. Alright, maybe let's pop out of this form. It's so slow. I think we got a scout in fox form. Oh, there's a part right in the middle of town. Okay. Let's go there as a chicken. Let's get the one in the middle of town. It would also be great if we didn't have 1.426 health. I took some free hits in the middle. Or early on, I took some free hits. Man, I kind of wanted to find more of these transform games just to see what people do. I mean, a lot of them seem kind of iffy. This one was, this one stood out. Oh no! The disguise failed me. There's nothing out here on this part of the map, I don't think. What a dummy. Although I can't find the other pieces of meat. Oh, I see one up there. Very ambiguous, these meat piles. Aww. Rest in peace, Foxy. Alright, let's give this another go.
I don't wanna know your name, 'cause you
Can't lose this guy. Alright, the rabbit one will have to do. Wait, the cows will... It looks like if you get too close to anything, it will eventually, it will reveal you. Just don't make eye contact, don't make eye contact. Dog. He's on to me. I want to get the meat that's in the center of town. I don't want to be too cocky. Get, oh here, this one. This is the one I would like. Fuck. I think my cover's blown. Okay. Nice. Okay, we got- No! God damn it. Man, there's like one too many enemies in these areas. It's like really very difficult. It is really difficult to get these meats that are in town. Did I get all the easy meat pieces of meat? I think I did. Oh, there's one by the pumpkins. Let's get the one by the pumpkins. We can make a straight shot for that. Should be pretty easy to get. Cows are loud. Oh, there's two pieces here? Alright. We'll make a run for it soon. If they see, are they gonna see me here? Oh, they're on to me. We can get that other piece pretty easily, I think. So peaceful out here. The fox jumped over the cow. Alright, let's get the- Why do they scream in this area? Alright, let's get the last one. Or not the last one, almost last one. This one. Oh wait, there's- okay, I can get the last one here too. This is a pretty easy zone to get meat. Oh, no one saw me. Oh, yeah. We're so close. I don't want to risk it. Alright, let's get the last pumpkin piece. They, maybe went a little overboard with the cow sound effects. That guy patrols away. Alright, we're in the clear. In the clear. Yay! Victorious fox on the run. I really like this. You know, it's a little simple, it was a little goofy, but it did a cool job with the transforming thing. It made me laugh with some of the goat stuff. This is very good. Very good game jam game. Good times. I hope you guys like this kind of, you know, weird little offbeat game. And I hope you guys enjoyed this kind of experimental video that I'm trying of just doing a bunch of random indie games. Not that it's a original idea or anything, but it's not something I've done on any of my platforms. So if you guys liked it, let me know. I'd love to have some feedback. And I had a good time with the good, the mediocre, and the bad. But I'm going to wrap up this vodcast, and I hope to see you guys on the next one. Momentai, thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys live next week. Take care.